Dear friends and family, greet you all in the most promising name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. It is such an honor to address you all on this auspicious occasion of the new year. May God bless you all on this very new year. May God bless you all and I wish you all a very happy new year. And my dear friends, on this day, His glorification, His gratifications must be the resolution for the year to come. I have set up 5 resolutions that may be helpful for you and me in this new year to come. So here are the 5 points that I would like to talk to you today. The first thing that I would like to talk to you today is about value the people around you. For really, what we basically do is we value things which are materialistic. We value our cars, we value our houses, we value all the materialistic thing that our heart is. But the thing that is to be valued is the people around us. Really, they are our treasures. They are like the earthen vessels that has been digged down into the earth. So in this new year, the first resolution that is to be resolved is to value the people around us. Nowadays, teenagers, the youngsters, people like me, people like you, they usually go around and forget about the people who are around them. Facebook, WhatsApp, and many other social medias have come thus far that we are connected to the people in America, but we are departed from the people who live with us in our own home. So it is time for us to resolve this very resolution that we start valuing the people around us in this new year. And the second resolution that I would like to put out here is respect and honor the relationship. I have seen in India there are thousands of cases that we see every day which is not in relation to a new marriage but in relation to divorce. People are divorcing, youngsters are breaking up. So what may be the reason that so many breakups and so many divorces, so many heartbreaking situations is being created in our country? The first and foremost reason that I see through the Bible is that we do not value our relationship. We do not honor and respect our relationship. The core thing that is needed in a relationship is honor and respect. Yes, we love each other. That's a good thing. But when we lack honor and respect, we lack the relationship, we lack the heart, we lack the core. So in this new year, I request you all to maintain the honor and respect in the relationship. And surely the respect and honor is not something that man has put in action. That has been established by God. So it is our sole responsibility that we re-stabilize the respect and honor that God has already put in the relationship. This is the second resolution that is to be resolved in the family, that we honor and respect our relationship. The third thing that I would like to speak to you today is about, we see in the book of Matthew chapter 5 verse 5. In that particular verse, Jesus says that be humble, be meek, for you will inherit the kingdom. You will inherit the kingdom. So what really does Jesus mean out here? It means that be meek as much as possible. Be humble as much as possible. Because you see that a fruitful tree is always humbled to the ground. So, in this new year, I know that there are thousands of accusations, there are false allegations, there are temptations, there are persecutions. But I urge you, brethren, that you be fruitful, that you be fruitful through meekness, you be fruitful through humbleness. One fine day, a boy, let me tell you a story, a little story. I'm not a very good storyteller, but let me tell you something about a boy. He was walking down the street. He was humbled to the ground. He was looking down, and one fine day, he found a diamond. So, brethren, if we want to find diamond, let us be meek, let us be humble. Look to the ground. Never forget the ground that we have grown up, that God has brought us from. So, many times, sky, the success, the achievement, the accomplishment, all the luxurious life, let us forget everything, forget the ground that we came from. So it is important for us to understand that in this new year, let us be humble, let us be meek. And the fourth thing that I would like to speak to you today is be open to responsibilities. Many of the youngsters, many of the old peoples, many of the families, many of the maritally joined couple, nowadays, they always want to blame someone if something goes wrong. If everything goes right, then everyone is very, very much keen to get the credit. But if something goes wrong, we are always keen to give that credit to someone. We always like to say, it is because of your fault that I am here. So stop doing that in this new year. Say that I am open for my responsibility. I am responsible for the things that goes in my life. Somehow we are responsible, brethren. We need to understand. It is not because the headmaster did not give me a good number and I couldn't get a good numbers and proper support. It is because of my lack of hard work that I did not get good marks. So it is important for us to realize today that yes, let us be open to responsibilities. Let us adapt ourselves to a situations where we can say, yes, I am open to responsibility. Yes, as a father, I am open to the responsibility of a father. I am open for the responsibility of a daughter. I am open for the responsibility of a son. I'm open for the responsibility of a mother, and it's not by an accident. It is all because of my continuous labor and my continuous trial. And the fifth thing that I would like to talk to you today is about from the book of Matthew chapter 5 verse 9. Jesus says, blessed are the peacemaker. Many times nowadays in the Indian serials, in the Indian serials, what we say, all the time what we see is, we see just a family dispute and exaggerating some things and bringing something to a higher level, making the non-issue an issue and creating a quarrel where there is no way for a quarrel. But my dear brethren, Jesus let us know, Jesus want us to know in this new year that let us be a peacemaker. Let us be peace lover. If we love peace, let us make peace everywhere. Wherever we go, wherever we are, whatever the situation is, Jesus always says, blessed are the peacemaker. If there is a quarrel, if there is a misunderstanding, then you and I are the responsible people to go and make peace out there. So these are the five resolutions that I have personally taken a note for the new year 2018. So here it is for you if you like it, and please implement it in the new year to come. Thank you very much for watching us. And if you want us to post more videos like this, if you want us to post more videos in English and Hindi and Nepali, so you can pass a comment or share the videos or whatever you want to do, you can do to it. And one more thing I would like to add, we do have a YouTube channel, we call it Sound for Christ, and surely it is a Sound for Christ. So if you would like to be updated with all our latest videos, you're welcome to do so. Thank you very much for tuning into us. Thank you.